Hi everybody, my name is Sheridan. I work at the Long Beach Public Library and I'm here today to show you how to make a found object picture frame using supplies that you probably already have at home. Pretty cool, huh? Before we get started though, if you haven't signed up for summer reading, be sure to do so by going to longbeach.beanstack.org. And if you've already signed up, enter the code PIRATE into the activities tab of your challenge to get a point for watching this video today. Cool? Okay, so before we get started, I want to talk a tiny bit about what found object art is. In 1917, a French artist by the name of Marcel Duchamp signed a name and put the date on a urinal that he found. He took this urinal and he took it to a gallery where there was an art competition happening, and he said that it was art. And it was really controversial because up until that point, art and sculpture was something that somebody put in a ton of time for, trained for years to do, and oftentimes had an insane amount of talent to be able to actually produce something that was called art. Duchamp completely obliterated that when he took this urinal and he called it art. He took this urinal and he recontextualized it. He took its original purpose, which is to serve as a bathroom, and he called it art and it became art. And so this is what Duchamp would call an objet trouvé, which means a found object, and it became art. And it changed the course and landscape of art forever. This had really, really influential consequences. For example, in 1936, Murray Oppenheim took a saucer, a teacup, and a spoon, covered it in fur, and called it art, called it sculpture. This is a little bit more surrealist and bent, but the point is that he didn't make the cup, the saucer, or the spoon, and he didn't make the fur. He just assembled the art from objects that he had found in the landscape around him. Really abstract, really controversial, and also really, really cool what's possible with what's just lying around you to turn it into art. So now I'm gonna show you how to take some stuff that's just around your house and turn it into your very own art, okay? So to make this found object picture frame, what you're gonna need is some cardboard or cardstock. I'm using some cereal boxes, which I'm sure you have at home. Cocoa Pebbles is one of my favorites, so I chowed down on the cereal and now I have the box to use into art. Also, I've got some pipe cleaners, some feathers, these little puffy billy bops, some markers, glue stick, a little bit of glitter glue, some washi tape, scissors, a pencil, a ruler, some little gems in case you want to make it, you know. And then I had these stickers laying around too, so I decided to use those as well. You can use glue or you can use tacky glue to attach the stuff. If you have a parent who's helping you, you can also use a hot glue gun, but be very careful with these because they get very, very hot. Leave that to the grown-ups, okay? And so we'll get started. In here, you can see that I've got a picture of myself and my grandmother. I'm reading her a letter when I was visiting her one day that her sister wrote her from Mexico City. My grandma can't read, so I just, you know, took the opportunity to read her the letter aloud, and my mom snapped a photo, and now it's one of my favorite photos of me and my grandma. So I framed that in this one. In the one that I'm going to show you how to make in the video, I'm going to frame a picture of myself and one of my really best friends, Sarah. And so I'll show you what to do. So earlier, before the video, I cut up a cereal box. As you can see, it was Fruity Pebbles, another one of my favorite cereals. And I took the two panels, the two biggest panels, the front and the back, to be able to form the frame. So you probably want to do this in pencil, but I'm going to do it with marker just so that you can see the lines. As you can see, the panel is a little bit bigger than my photo. This is a 5x7 photo, but you can do a smaller one if you like, or even a bigger one if you like, if you have a big cardboard box or something like that. So what I want to do is I want to measure, using my ruler, about how, if I put this about in the middle, how wide that is. So it looks like it's about an inch. I'm not sure if you can see that, but it hits about the one. So from the bottom of the photo, I'm gonna measure another inch and I'm gonna draw a little dot. From one side, a little dot there, and on the other side, a little dot there. And then using the ruler, I'm gonna connect those two dots with a line. And this line is gonna be then an inch all around the photo. And using some scissors, I'm just going to cut off the excess cardboard. Cool. So this is going to be the back of our frame. What we need to do with this other panel is do the same thing. Now that you've already got one that's the correct size, you can just lay it on top and cut it out. Or if you really feel like it, you can also trace the line onto it and then cut it that way. I'm just going to cut it out like this. So. All right. Perfect. So now I've got two panels that are going to serve as my picture frame. Okay. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to try to cut out a rectangle in the middle of this panel to be able to actually see the photo that's in the frame. I'm going to lay this photo on top, and very carefully, so I don't actually mark the photo, I'm going to mark the four points that are on the end of the four corners of the photo. I'm not sure if you can tell, but as you can see, I've marked four little dots, right? And then what I'm going to do, you don't want to actually put any lines on this photo just yet, because what you're going to be doing is you're actually going to be cutting a rectangle that's smaller than the photo by just a tiny bit. Next up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure a quarter of an inch into diagonally from the dot. So this seems confusing, right? But I've got the dot here, and because I want this rectangle to be smaller, a little bit smaller than my photo, I'm just going to measure a quarter of an inch into the rectangle. So I'm going to do that for all four, okay, on a diagonal. And then that way, the photo doesn't slip out of the front of the frame when you've got it in there. I'm just going to do that real quick for all four points. So as you can see now, I've got four points on my rectangle where I'm going to start drawing lines to cut it out. These four points are actually smaller than my photo by a tiny bit. My photo covers them up, right? So now I'm going to draw lines and cut it out. Perfect. So as you can see now, I've got a frame, right? The front of the frame, and I've got the back of the frame. I'm going to test it out real quick by putting my picture in the middle and putting this on top. And as you can see, it covers the white part of the photo, and then that way I'm sure that my photo will not fall out of the frame. So we're about halfway done. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to take my glue stick and I'm going to apply glue to three sides of the frame. Unless you want this photo to be in this frame forever, you really only want to do three sides of the frame so you can slide the photo in and out easily. So I'm going to do the bottom, and I'll show you guys what I'm doing in just a sec, the side and the top. Be careful not to put any glue stick onto your actual photo because you don't want to damage it or get it all sticky. But as you can see, I put glue stick onto all these three sides of the frame, and then that way I can slide this photo out by this side. And then take the top of your frame and measure it so it's nice and flush, and press down on that glue to make it dry. Okay? So now you're pretty much done with the frame construction of part of this. And now what's left is to turn this found object that we cut up a little bit, and with other found objects, decorate it to make it into a piece of art for yourself and your family. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna take some of these markers, I think I'll do orange, and I'm just gonna color the frame. You can choose whatever color you'd like though. You can do more than one color, you can draw designs on it. It's your art, you can do whatever you'd like, right? You can see my frame is orange, and now I'm gonna start kind of, you know, gluing stuff to it. Maybe I'll put a little bit of swirl of glitter glue in one of the corners, you know, or four of the corners, who knows? Maybe I'll, you know, get a little crazy here. The idea here is to get as creative as you want. And maybe I'm going to stick a couple of these little billy bops on there with the hot glue. If you're using hot glue, be very, very careful, or have your parent do it so that way you don't burn yourself. It can be really, really painful to burn yourself with hot glue. Trust me, I've been there. So now I've got some glitter glue. I've got some of these little doohickeys on here. Maybe I think I'm gonna add some feathers. This is the open side of my frame, so just remember where that is. But I think I'm gonna add some feathers to the top here. Put a little bit of hot glue there. You can also use tacky glue, or even just like white glue if you have that. Put some feathers there. And it doesn't have to be perfect, it's your art. And it's art because you say it's art. That's why it's art. You can see I've got some puffballs, some glitter glue, some feathers. I think maybe I'm also gonna add a couple of gems here to the other side. Just gonna take my hot glue and very carefully lay down some hot glue here. Be sure to have extra hot glue sticks on hand because otherwise it makes it really difficult. This craft is a great way to use up any, you know, like little extra craft supplies that you had from other projects, or, you know, little pieces of yarn if you want to get super, you know, more of a textile kind of feel. It's just a great way to use up extra craft supplies and anything else you have, you know, around the house. So I think now I'm done with the decoration portion of my frame. I've got some glitter on it, I've got some feathers, these little billy bops, some gems, and now I think I'm ready to put in the photo. Before you put in your photo, be sure that all the objects and stuff are dry so that way it doesn't damage the photo in case you want to use it in another frame later. But I'm just going to go ahead and put it in so that you can see how it works. Because I left this side unglued, what I can easily do is just very carefully slide the photo into the frame. Sometimes it takes a little bit of doing. And as you can see, the photo went in. If you put too much glue on one of the sides, it's very possible that the photo may not go all the way to the end, and that's okay. But I think this photo is pretty well centered. So as you can see, now I've got my photo in there. It's me and my friend Sarah, and we've got a little frame that I made out of found objects, and it is art. And it's a great way to memorialize our friendship and the many years that we've known each other. Over here, I've got my grandma in another found object frame. And I can put this on the fridge or in my room or, you know, wherever I want to. Thank you so much for joining me today. Hopefully you had a great time and you can make your own found object frames. If you do decide to make the frames, feel free to share them with us on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook. We'd love to share them with the rest of the Long Beach community, okay? Take care. Have a great summer. Bye.